primarily where I would use it, clamp it back, clamp it, and that's it. Hey guys, Brad here. Today we're gonna take a look at some Festool clamps and which ones you should get and which one is my favorite. I love Festool tools and these clamps are really easy to use. Not only that, they save me a lot of time. They work with tracks. They're just an all-round awesome thing to have if you are on the Festool platform. So I'm gonna run you through each clamp here and show you which one I love the most and which clamp is the fastest to use out of all three of these. The first clamp is the one that they came out with a long time ago. This is the screw clamp. This is a hold down clamp. So this style of clamp works not only on the MFT table, but it also works on the tracks. So if you've got a track like this one, it's specially designed to fit into the grooves. So it can fit right on the top here, slides in, can also fit on the bottom, which is primarily where I would use it. And you clamp your track to your material like that. So it's a good clamp. However, I never use it. I don't like the screwing mechanism on it. I find it's a bit of a pain. It's not very fast. So this one has just really taken a back shelf and sat in a box for years. Now this clamp, I absolutely love. This is their quick clamp. This is same sort of design, except it has a ratcheting system in here. So if you wanted to clamp down some wood, you would throw it in your hole. You just slide this down, clamp it back. So that is really, really in there. That is super strong. It doesn't mar up the work. To release it, you just press the button, it comes out. Now here's the part that I don't like about these clamps. Sometimes when you're trying to take them out, they get jammed up in here, especially if you have stuff under the table, which I always seem to have. So if you do, sometimes you cannot fully get them in. So you can see it gets snagged there. So that's one little pet peeve I have. Obviously it's not a deal breaker, but that is one thing that happens sometimes if you have stuff underneath your table. These again work just like this previous clamp. They will slide into the track, no problem. These are way faster. So you slide it into the track. You have your material here, slide it up, and then you lock it in place. Now the latest clamp by Festool is a game changer, I think. This thing does not have a U-shape to it. You just strictly put it in the hole, put your product here, slide it down, make sure it's open, clamp it, and that's it. And you can open it up and take it right out. Now it's a fairly tight fit. They say you can only clamp up to 3 1/8 of an inch. However, I think you can stretch to 3.5 if you really wanted to. So here is a 2x4. Measuring 3.5 inches. You can see if I put this in, I just push down on it a bit, I can still get it clamped. Now I would recommend using two clamps. So you just slide that guy in here, clamp that down. So it's in there, it's not super solid, but it is working. So 3 1/8 is probably a better representation of what it'll actually do, but it does work on 3.5 as well. Now, the only downside to these clamps is that they do not work with the track. And that's okay. I mean, not everything has to work with the track. These are the best for the track by far. They're so strong. Now, as far as capacity goes, these will only do 5.5 inches when you're using it on a table. So from here to here, that's 5.5 inches. They're saying this only does 3 1/8, and this one here does about 4 3/4. So there's a big difference between all three sizes. It really depends on what you need to be doing. If you like what you're seeing, make sure you subscribe, hit that notify bell, and give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Definitely leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you what kind of clamps you're using and what you think of the Festool clamps. So I love these clamps because they're so quick for holding down your material. They are very impressive. You just slap it down, and again, super, super strong. They are not gonna allow the material to come out. So if you're cutting or if you're using your domino right here, you're coming in from behind, let's say, your material is not going to push away. The way these clamps work, you can see in here, there's a cam-like device. So this is just oblonged. So as you push it down, this green piece here pushes the plastic down, just like that. So that's all it is for holding down your work. Very easy, whereas these ones, you've got the ratcheting system inside, And I do find that you can get a better hold with these because you can really crank down on it. But quite frankly, you're not using this to clamp material together if you're gluing. You're just using it to clamp it to a table or clamp your track down to some material. So you don't need to be reefing on it so that you're actually like bending metal or breaking wood here. You just need to hold it while you're working on it. Now these do fit really tight. So getting them out, you can hear it kind of rubbing there. That is a very tight fit, but that's what you need when you're using it on a table. You need that real tight friction fit. I am surprised that Festool didn't come out with a longer rod or maybe a screw-on attachment or something. So who knows? Hopefully they come out with maybe a 12-inch or an 8-inch. That'd be nice for larger pieces of lumber if you're building furniture or something like that. This gets the job done if you're building a table, let's say, or a cutting board. These will hold down no problem for your sanding, putting dominoes in, whatever you need to do. So I highly recommend getting two clamps of each. Depending on what you're doing, if you're gonna get this clamp, get two of them. I know for a fact that these come in singles, but I would get two because you really do need two if you're gonna be doing some big cutting. One is handy, but you know, you can still move it around like this. So if you throw a second one in here, now you're not gonna be able to move it. So having two clamps really does make a difference. Same with these guys, having two of these makes a huge difference, especially if you're using the track, you wanna put one at each end. And this guy as well, you know, for track, you can put one at each end. You can also use this to hold down like this, screw it down. It works great, but it's just not my preferred clamp. It just takes too long. And why use this when you can use these? So if you want to attach your track down to a piece of material, it's super easy. You just take your clamp, slide it down, slide this up to your material, and just lock it in place. And that's it. Now your track is locked on. Now you can throw another clamp on the other end, or you can just leave it. Pretty much all the time I'm cutting with a track saw, I am not using a clamp. The only time I'm using a clamp on these things is when I'm using my router, because the router has a sideways push to it with the router bit turning. So you really want to make sure you're clamped down because it can start to sort of move on you. The track saw, you're cutting in this direction. The pads on the bottom of the track stick so well to the material that it really doesn't move. So I rarely clamp my tracks down to my wood. Now there's so many different scenarios how you can use a track saw. Cutting down sheet goods, cutting doors down, cutting fences, whatever you might do, cutting decks. You can take a track and you can put it up on a side like this and clamp it right to a door. The ability to clamp your track to anything is quite remarkable. I love this system. My favorite clamp right now has got to be this clamp though, for one reason only, and that's just the speed at how I can just clamp this work right down to the table and I'm good to go. I find it's a little easier and faster than this. This is more of a two-handed job. You have to kind of hold it like that and then clamp it in. So that's kind of two-handed, whereas this, I can just do it with one hand, drop it in, clamp it, and I'm good to go. All right, guys, I hope this video was helpful. These are the clamps that I use all the time. If you like the video, make sure you subscribe, hit that notify bell, give me a thumbs up if you like it. And definitely put some questions, comments down below. I'd love to hear from you. What clamps are you using? There's so many out there that you can pick. Doesn't have to be Festool, obviously. But until next time, keep on crushing it. We'll catch you later.